My, 27M, fiancé, 26F, called my life pitiful for not having best man. I have a fiancé and we're planning to get married next year. As all couples before marriage would do, we shared our life experiences and such multiple times. We were watching a realistic marriage movie one day and discussing our marriage plan. I told her before that due to how I had to move around countries quite often, not to mention some military enrollment experience in my life, I don't really have any close friends right now. And probably no best man as my friend. And we came to the topic of the wedding day. She said, "What a pitiful life you have for not having a close friend." I was seriously dumbstruck, as that was kinda my complex. Though she and I both enjoy spending most of the time just the two of us, she would occasionally mention that it's sad I don't have close friends. I was hurt for sure when I heard that. And only after me saying it's painful to hear that from my fiancé, she said it was a joke. I don't know if I should just brush it off or have a deep conversation about it with her. She's been insensitive on certain topics from time to time. I can laugh at most of them, but sometimes it seriously hurts a lot. Hashtag update. Thanks for all the kind comments. I was discussing with my fiancé for 56 hours, and I also explained how my situation made it really difficult to make close friends. The frequent moving, getting out from the military after an incident, the new job, etc. Also, I have both male and female friends, yes, but no close enough friends to be the best man. Let me just make myself clear on that part. She was saying sorry about what she said over and over again. Maybe because I was telling her how I truly felt about her, jokes, that happens ever so often. I do feel like she feels sorry about what happened, and hopefully, with more effort and time, we can continue our relationship even stronger. P.S. Something more to add though. She's almost always sweet but gets somewhat disheartened when I talked with my female friends before. She told me she was getting somewhat jealous. So I lessened the contact with my female friends, for us to get together more, be content, and she did the same with her male friends too. Hey man, sorry this happened. Are you both native English speakers or is it a translation? If it's the first and she actually used the phrase, pitiful life, I wouldn't just let that go. It's not funny, it's only hurtful and mean. Is she making those jokes frequently? I'm all up for a friendly banter, but this was just plain cruel. Take care, mate. She's been insensitive on certain topics from time to time. I mean if this happens regularly, I'd postpone the wedding and get into individual and couples counseling to see if you can get on the same page first. You need that deep conversation. Don't marry someone who does not respect you. You will never have a happy day with your spouse. If she says these things now, I can only imagine what she will say when you two are already married, with kids, and she gets upset about something. Though her and I both enjoy spending most of the two of us, she would occasionally mention that it's sad I don't have close friends. How many close friends does she have? Why is it sadder for you than it is for her, if she doesn't have friends either? This sounds a lot like the Schrödinger douchebags effect. When you say something offensive to somebody but only react according to their reaction. If you are hurt, they say they are joking to avoid backlash. If you agree, they do not say they are joking. Look it up, please. This is exactly what is happening. You are being manipulated, in my opinion. She finds humor in being cruel to someone she loves? Stellar. Let's be real. She only said it was a joke once she realized she hurt your feelings, which also means she thought it was completely okay to be mean to you. Not okay. Get into couples therapy now, before marriage. Contempt is a really bad thing in relationships. It's not something you should just brush off. Oh, she's not joking, man. She straight up thinks you're pathetic. Those jokes are only a mask. She means what she's saying and you know it. I will be with another man for a couple days, she said. After having sex, she, F45, said that she has to ask me, 45M, something, kind of unsure about asking. I invited a friend to come over for a couple days for Christmas. He is an old friend. She said. I ask, what is the question? Because that sounds like a fact. Then she asks, well, I want to know if you will be fine with this? Will this upset you or made you mad at me? I said, well, it will be weird, but I do not think that I should be mad at all because you are telling me and I am guessing that you aren't more than friends, correct? To what she said, yes, we are friends from many years ago. He has been in my house before with her girlfriend, but he doesn't have a girlfriend now. But I want to mention that I have zero attraction for him. I just thought to let you know just in case that you might want to come over and so you won't have a surprise about who this guy is. I thanked her for being honest, followed by, because I do have female friends that could sleep under my same roof without wanting to sleep with them at all, I can relate. so I am being oblivious on this, or did I do the right thing? Note. We are recently dating, but we are keeping some kind of emotional distance, as per my suggestion because I come from a mental abusive relationship and I wasn't looking to start a new relationship at all. We have great conversations, we enjoy cuddling, meals together, so it's not a simple hookup or FWB that just jump on bed to do our thing, and left. I know it's complicated to explain, but we have the agreement to be exclusives. The question really becomes one of trust. Can you trust her? Have you built enough trust between each other? That really is the question. Is she also inviting you to stay with her during this time? I've been friends with some of my guy friends for a long time. There's one in particular that has stayed the night with me and with my family on occasion. My boyfriend really wouldn't care if the dude crashed on my couch. And one of my BF's greatest friends is a woman. She's great, and I wouldn't mind at all if she needed to crash on his couch. This is such a situational matter. Depends how much you trust her. Sounds like she's saying you're still welcome to come over and be with her, she just didn't want you to be surprised if you saw her friend over. It's really up to you on how much you trust her. If she's still including you and having you over and everything is the same as far as how you two interact, then I don't see a problem. If she was saying you can't be around when the friend is there or starts acting weird towards you, then I'd consider that red flags. If you are going to be a part of her life in the long term, then this person would become your friend too and she should want you to be there with them. You can tell most Redditors are just people who just read up dating words like trust and shit with no real life experience LMAO. So now you can even find someone make a post saying, I walked in on my girlfriend standing naked with her ex-FWB, and some people here would still go, can you trust your partner? If you trust her then you have nothing to worry about. LMFAO. This is actually a mature conversation and a perfectly fine thing to happen. The other comments come from a place of insecurity. Friendships are genderless and can evolve to a family feeling if the connection is great and long-lasting. And people don't get horny and fucked just because they are alone in a house. People who are suspect of their partner spending time alone with an opposite gender friend don't trust them or themselves enough to be in a healthy relationship. You're doing the right thing by trusting her and your reason. If you believe the only thing stopping your significant other from cheating is that they don't have access to other people, there are deeper trust issues at play. Women and men can be friends and be alone together without it being sexual. This should be normal. This sounds like healthy communication to me. One of my best friends, whose family to me is my ex-boyfriend, I'd trust him with my life, it's not all bad. Wife, 43 female, cheated on me 2 years ago. We decided to stay together now. I think I made a mistake. 2 years ago my wife cheated on me while on a work trip. She was enjoying a night out with some colleagues when she met a guy hooked up with him, but they didn't have sex. I am sure that they didn't have sex because her company is very strict about bringing anyone to the rooms when someone is on official trip, they could lose their job. She confessed the next morning and we did some counseling and finally we decided to reconcile. Then COVID lockdown hit and the whole world turned to shish t. But we kept reconciling. Here I am 2 years later, thinking that I made a mistake. Don't get me wrong, she has been the model spouse the whole time and we didn't drive each other mad during the lockdowns, so that's something. But lately I have been getting the feeling that I am living a lie. From getting up in the morning to going back to sleep during the night, I am playing a role. I feel like I am wearing a mask of someone else and the real me is lost somewhere. I don't know if I am making sense right now. I guess I just needed to get it off my chest. It's my first post in here, so I don't know if what I wrote will be accepted or not. I just want some peace. You're allowed to change your mind. You can't forgive her. That's okay. Sometimes people do unforgivable things to us. You are allowed to not forgive someone. But you have to accept that you can't forgive her. Let her and yourself go. So they couldn't go to her room. What about his? Or someplace else? When you're drunk and horny, you get very creative. Bottom line is that reconciliation is a trial, and it sounds like it hasn't worked for you. You're allowed to change your mind and call it quits. Infidelity is the gift that keeps on giving. Also, I don't buy they never had sex. They always have sex. It's in the cheater's handbook to say they didn't. Very strict about bringing anyone to the rooms when someone is on official trip, they could lose their job. So she went to his room, the toilets. You tried to forgive her when it's probably not forgivable to you and you don't want to be with her anymore. That is very valid. Most people won't stay with a partner after they've cheated, they can never trust them again. It's time to break up and move on. so she has the moral compass to abide by company rules, but hooking up while she has a partner is perfectly fine? THR analogy people always use about reconciliation after infidelity is that it's like trying to flatten out a crumpled up piece of paper. The relationship is just not going to be the same. Maybe you are experiencing this? My boyfriend looked up real rape videos. There was a few porn rape videos, but then I also saw that he was looking up actual rape videos. He watched a video of a 19-year-old woman being beaten and raped to death and had watched another leaked raped video. He kept trying to search to find more actual rape videos. I don't know how to feel. He also likes looking at death and gore and people getting murdered. I feel so traumatized after finding this on his history. He looked this up while I was gone for only a day. I had left because he started drinking every week. He used to never drink before, and I have never seen nor been around him drinking, and he was drinking the night before he looked all of that up. He kept saying he was not drunk and had sex with me and was being very aggressive and was doing sexual things without asking me, and then after that night I left. I find all of this on his history that he had looked up next night. Don't even break up with him, don't say another word to the man. Block him on everything and leave it at that. If he's looking up that shit, who knows how he's going to take the breakup. Get as far away from him as possible. Get as far away from this man as possible, and stay safe. That is not something to brush over, and I'm so sorry. Please break up with this man now. You leave. You don't second guess. You don't try to understand. You don't give him a chance to explain. You leave. There can be no possible justification for finding gratification or entertainment in viewing what you have described. There is something profoundly wrong with him. Please report him, even if it's just so that the local police have something on file. If he does go on to harm someone, or God's forbid, worse, then having something on record makes a successful prosecution more likely. Oh, and get the hell out of there. Don't tell him. Don't discuss anything. Just get out and break off all contact. Right now you are the easy potential victim. Please, please get out and stay safe. Leave. He's going to commit a crime soon. He's escalating. It started out with looking it up on the internet, and now that's starting to not be enough for him, he has turned to drinking to help fight urges. He's being sexually aggressive with you and doing things without your consent. He's testing out what he wants on you. He's going to rape someone soon, and if you don't get out, that someone could be you. This is him escalating into committing real crime. He's now associating sex with violence. This is serious.